Oh.
The Hutchison High School Stream Team is made up of students in the Arts AV cluster at Hutchison High School. This young group of creative students dedicate their time after school and on the weekend to produce live event broadcasts. These events are streamed live over the World Wide Web for audiences across the state, the nation, and even worldwide. Of note, we are particularly proud of a recent volleyball broadcast which was viewed by deployed family members in Afghanistan. Our team uses high-end production equipment, including multiple cameras, mass communication headsets, live video switchboards, live tiling, and even an instant replay generator to produce incredibly high-quality and engaging content for our viewers. The team is made up of between 6 to 10 high school students, each in unique positions, responsible for a certain aspect of the show, yet all moving in sync to bring the best possible viewing experiences to our audience. Our team started in March of 2010 and to date has produced over 100 live streams. We began mainly producing streams in our own home school, but have since mobilized our equipment and have done various events around the state. It is always an exciting experience for us to produce these streams, but the real reward is being able to bring live coverage of special events to parents and fans who are unable to make the often long trips around our great state.
Alrighty, welcome everyone to the girls' game of the 40th Annual Valdez Elks Tournament here, where the Seward Lady Seahawks will be going up against the Cordova Lady Wolverines. Before we get started here, we're going to send you to our player inner, our little player intros here for the Cordova Wolverines.
I'm Taylor Gatto. I'm going to be the man behind the mic today. Thank you guys for watching this great stream we put together for you. And make sure you guys donate to us. We like to put together these great streams for you.
Hey, I'm Miranda Schiff. I'm a junior. And thanks for coming to the Hutchison High School stream team.
Hi, I'm Sophia Squires. I'm a freshman. Thanks for watching stream team.
Hi, my name's Aaliyah. I'm a freshman. Thanks for watching.
Hi, my name's Estelle Hallbrooks. I'm a freshman, and thanks for watching.
Hey, guys, I'm Jade Fine. I'm a senior, and thanks for watching Stream Team.
Hey, guys, I'm Bernadette Quinn. I'm a junior, and thanks for watching Stream Team.
I'm Daniel Montague. I'm a junior, and thanks
for... Like, how holds the ball in her arm, hand right there. I'd be scared to lose the ball right there and drop it. Fighting for the ball right there. No jump ball call
nice.
Right there. Good rip right there, and that's Peebles there on the layup. Bad pass right there, able to keep it alive. Another bad pass, Navarro.
Ooh, right through the hands.
Speedster on the layup, no good. And they take it to the floor there, jump ball. Possession stays with Cordova. Kick out there for Navarro. Inside there to Vargas. Vargas drives, layup up, no good. Jackson brings it down the floor. Jackson, a little bit of a fighter. She took some shots yesterday, one in the face. I think she landed on her back once and hurt her wrist. She's a fighter. She keeps fighting. She looks 100% today, ready to fight. Layup up there, no good. And then the rebound, that's Alea Lapkins. And we have a timeout called here by the Wolverines. I talk some things over, maybe come up with a out-of-bounds press break. So while we have a moment here, we're going to, if you want to send any kind of cheers, you want to send anything about a little shout-out to the cheerleaders, the coaches, the players, the team, text it into that 702-276-7723. Once again, the number is 702-276-7723, as you see it on your screen. We'll read them live to you as the game is being aired. Both teams hitting the floor. Yeah. Navarro drives, kicks out to Vargas. The drive, kicks out. Long lob pass right there, almost got stolen. Vargas. Layup up there by Navarro, no good. Rebound Seward. Jackson down the floor. Ball is tipped out of bounds by Navarro, stays with Seward.
Lipinski's on 20 on Seward Seahawks here. She's pretty tall.
Yeah, tallest. I think tall is one of the tallest girls in the tournament.
Wow. Nice save.
Good hustle. And, yeah, back to she is the tallest girl here. I'm pretty sure in the tournament, so big and long, it's so easy for her. At the point, she doesn't even have to jump to get the rebound. Just put her hands up and there's the ball. Jackson drives, kicks out. The deep two there is good.
Nice shot.
That is Von Borstel. Von Borstel had a good night last game. Didn't come out with the victory, of course, but she's a really good shooter. And tip out of bounds there. That's Moriety. Rebound Seward. The jump shot there at the free throw line. Girls take a hard shot on the rubber right there. That's gonna leave a mark. We'll get a replay right here. The nice little jump shot right there. Body's flying. Looks like she hit her face on the ground.
Ouch.
That was 42 for the Wolverines. That's Peebles. The baseball pass right to Navarro. The layup around the rim and out. She gets her own rebound. Back up again. No good. Peebles on the layup this time, and she is fouled. Up there, good.
One.
The hoop and the harm. That's a Borges right there. Using her body right there, taking the contact like a champ and going up, finishing the layup with the foul. Second free throw, up and good. Up coming into the game.
You gotta start talking, lady. Just adding your little tidbits. What good hustle they're doing.
All righty, Ashley Jackson at the free throw line. As you see the replay right here. Goes up on the layup right there. Gets fouled. Jackson, no good on the free throw right there. Jackson on the second free throw. is up, and it rolls around. No good. Vargas bringing the ball down the floor. Laro on the wing. Wide open for three.
She did get in her face there last minute.
Yeah, a little bit of contest. Body's on the ground there. Had a jump ball right there, and it's going to go to Seward.
Get open for that shot.
Jackson loses the ball right there. Body's on the floor. Layup, no good, but she is fouled.
Rolled right off the rim there.
A tough finish right there. Well, luckily she got the ball there off the loose ball right there and goes up on the layup and gets fouled. First free throw up for her, no good, off the front of the rim. Second free throw for her, up, and it is around the rim and in.
Nice. Pretty tight game we've got going on here.
Yeah, glad to see it. You know, the games yesterday, I don't know if any of them were within like 10 of each other. They were all pretty lopsided. So we hope to see some great games coming for day two of this tournament. Jackson on the wing. Takes it out into the corner. Jumper up, no good, but the rebound gets sent away. That was Koreski on the layup right there, gets rejected. Three-pointer, no good. Rebound of Aro.
That would have took him to the lead.
Yeah, that would have given him the lead right there. That's a big three miss right there. But plenty of time still to go. 2:30 left here in the first quarter here. Cordova up one. Navarro, top of the key. On the wing is Borges. Skip pass over to Vargas.
She looked like she was about to cut through there.
Yeah, it looked like she was going to drive. Maybe saw a little too much, too many green jerseys in there, because it looks like Seward's packing the pan with that 3-2 zone. Borges on the floater, no good. Jackson gives it up to Terry, back over to Morai. And we have a foul call right here on Navarro, reaching across the body there.
Bounced right to the ref there.
And we have another foul there on Navarro there. That's her... I think that's her second foul right there. Got to be careful. Don't want to get that third foul early, especially in the first quarter. And a travel is called right there against Von Borstel. Borges on the wing, kicks it over Navarro. Navarro stops the drive. Vargas.
Looks like she got a little nervous there.
Yeah, it looked like she was about to take a shot there. Got nervous and then made a mistake, turned it over. Jackson over.
Jackson.
Jackson wide open for three, no good. Forgus bringing down the ball. Overthrowing Vargas right there, it's a turnover. Jackson drives, kicks out, loose ball right there, and that's going to be a backcourt violation. And that's going to do it here for your first quarter here. Cordova will go up here 6-5 here, very low scoring, good defensive sets here, missing some shots early. So we're going to, while this break happens, we're going to send you down to our supervisor, Mr. Johnson. He's going to go through all our gear and tech for our stream team.
Job on that commentary. Good game here, 6-5. So we got a lot going on. We got a lot going on down here too. We take a little tour. You can see this is our TriCaster switchboard here. Estelle here running all four cameras, choosing what's live at what time. Crazy switchboard, split screens, all that stuff. Over here, Morgan, she's in charge of instant replay, fast, slow graphics for name bars. We've got photo slideshows being put together over at the end. Sophia's taking care of scoreboard. It's a huge setup. We've been here all day yesterday, 8 a.m. to 10 p.m., all day today, big day, and a big day tomorrow for all the championships. But we thank you all for tuning in. Don't forget, top of the link, click donations. You got to mail it in. I know that's kind of weird, but find your checkbook, mail in a donation so we can make this kind of thing happen so you guys can watch at home from free. Back to Taylor and Chantel.
All right, awesome. Thank you, Mr. Johnson. We appreciate you giving us a tour and telling us how hard we actually work. Because, you know, it does take weeks to prepare all these kind of things with our graphics and such. So we do appreciate your support and willingness to help us out and make us a better people because of it. As I get back onto the floor here, Seward, that was Moriety with the tip. And Lapkins will check back into the game. Vargas, the deep two is good.
Nice shot.
Jackson, bounce pass into the corner, back to Jackson. Three-pointer up, cash
nice.
It in. As a three-pointer there for Terry. First three-pointer out the game, for that matter.
Looks like we're tied up now.
Swing out. Vargas over to Vargas. Vargas pump fakes. And it is stolen away. And the bad pass right there just goes right out of bounds. Jackson not really looking where she was passing right there. Kind of just passed it to a player streaking to the basket. But she was passing it to someone that was going to the corner. So a turnover there for a Seward. Who's over there? Navarro in the corner gets a pass right there, gets tipped out of bounds. Quarter over to inbound, almost stolen away. Back out to the corner, back inside. The layup there was no good. Vargas goes back up. the high arcing nice. Layup right there. Didn't even touch the backboard there, just straight up and down.
Even though you're right under the basket, sometimes it is hard to get it right when you're right underneath it.
Yeah, that is for sure right there. She made it work, though, on the other end. Shot right there got tipped out of bounds. Stays with Seward. Pump fake inside. Layup up and good. That's Lapkins. Drive there. Vargas kicks out to Navarro. Navarro for three. No good.
It's a little over.
And a timeout called here by Seward. A quick 30-second timeout there. Both teams playing pretty well. You know, just not finishing on the offensive end, which can happen. Just both teams running, executing well in their offensive and defensive sets. That's why the score is only 10-10 with 5 minutes left in the second quarter.
If you guys want to send in any cheers, just text 702-276-7723 and we'll read them live for you.
Definitely. Alrighty. Whole team's coming back onto the floor here. All right, Jackson bringing the ball up the floor. Inside. The layup up there is good. That's Riley von Borstel on the finish. Seward takes a 12-10 lead if you look at the replay right there, which is now gone. Jump shot there, no good. Rebound Seward. Jackson bringing it down the sideline, crosses over. Kicks out, three ball, short.
Air ball.
Good save right there. Almost got it knocked off Peebles legs right there. Skip pass over, that's a Tabara. Long floater there off the glass.
That was a nice shot. Oh, someone's on the floor.
Yeah, Vargas was running to get back. Didn't see the girl there, kind of just knocked her over.
Oh.
Von Borstel.
Another girl on the floor.
Yeah, Von Borstel there goes up on the layup there. Offensive foul is called. Navarro. Good pass inside there. Just lost the handle on it. That was Peebles inside. Ripped. Navarro almost with the steal. Or excuse me, that was Tabara.
Making sure to keep 24 right in the middle there with her height.
Oh, for sure. Getting around a rim is the best thing. Three there, no good, short.
Threw three players' hands there.
Now that ball can just become a thing of butter, it seems like. Sometimes just sliding out of people's hands all the time. Looking around. Looking inside. Jump shot is good. That's Lapkins. Navarro. Borges. Back inside. Over to Vargas.
Doing good on passing there.
And there we have it. Navarro splashing from the wing.
With a three. on the floor again.
Bodies flying everywhere. It's another jump ball called. Possession stays with Seward.
I feel like girls end up on the floor more than the guys do.
Yeah, you know, it's really just a situation kind of deal, like, as another girl's on the floor. I don't know, I just feel like, contact, like, usually, you know, guys take the contact, you know, they try to stay up. It just seems, I don't know. It's just a weird thing. I don't know. I don't know how to explain it, I guess. But Jackson on the free throw, off the front of the rim. Jackson on the second free throw, nothing but net. Scores tied at 15 here, about less than 3 minutes left here in the second quarter. Navarro gets caught right in the middle of the paint there, and we have a travel called there. She kind of just went right into the middle of the paint where five Seward jerseys were just chilling, and turnover.
Cordova leaving 33 wide open.
Jackson drives. And we have a foul off the ball here. That's on 22 for Cordova. That is Navarro. Sub coming into the game for the Wolverines. That's number 32, Ashley Witso. Wide open layup there. That's Lapkins. Kind of hard to stop her when she stands like 5 inches over you. On the wing. Borges goes into the corner there. A little bit of contact there. Lapkins tips it away. Jackson drives. More bodies on the floor there. Jackson's going to go to the line down and shoot two more free throws. It looked like Peebles tried to take a charge there, kind of just fell over. Jackson on the first free throw is up, and it is rolling around the rim and in. Score 18-15 here, about less than 2 minutes left in the second quarter.
Two for two.
Jackson was struggling at the free throw line in the first quarter there, went to the line, missed both of them, so good to see that she's, you know, getting back into rhythm. Seward only up four here with about a minute 45 in the game, in the second quarter. Steal there by Jackson. Von Borstel at the top of the key. Jump shot up and cash money.
Nice shot.
That's Molly right there.
He's on the floor.
I think they just tripped over each other's feet right there trying to go for the ball. A little lob pass in there trying to insert into Von Borstel to get stolen away. Kind of predictable right there.
Five subbing in, 4:15, 33.
Jackson bringing the ball down the floor. Lapkins stands in the middle. Easy layup inside right there.
Left her open.
That's Molly once again. Seward taking an 8-point lead right now with about 20 seconds left in the second quarter. And we have a foul right there. Going up against Seward. One more and they're in the bonus. Vargas drives, tries to pull up for a jumper at the buzzer, no good. And that's going to do it here for your first half. Scores 23-15 with Seward in the lead. Okay, so we're gonna take a little bit of break here and wait till the second half begins. But first, we're going to leave you with the second quarter highlights here presented by the Hutchinson High School stream team.
Are you a shriveled brown root? Because I am looking for a date.
Actually, what I think you need is a pair.
Those space pants? Because your legs are out of this world.
No, they are baseball pants because I am out of your league.
Thank you. Roses are red, violets are blue. I would really love to go to prom with you.
Oh, how sweet. I would love to go to prom with you.
Thank you.
right, guys, welcome back to the game live here in Valdez. We are watching Cordova versus the Seward Seahawks here. And the score is now 15-23 in period 3. And before we get started here, we'd just like to say that we are accepting donations to our school for Hutchison High School here, and all donations help. And if you'd like to send in a cheer, text the number 702-276-7723. Again, that number is 702-276-7723. And there's your number right there on the screen there. Looks like Cordova starting off with the ball. 12 at the top of the key and passes it to 22. At the top now looking for the pass and passes it to 12. Now Seward has the ball and is running down the court and loses control. 42 on Cordova picks it back up.
Another body on the floor once again.
Yes. 44 with the shot and it's no good. 20 with the shot on the three, and it's good.
That's Tabara there. Tabara not known for a three-point shooting. That's usually Navarro's game. But, you know, she'll hit one if she has two.
Yeah. And 22 with the ball for Seward. Up with the layup, but gets packed by Cordova.
She'll go to line, though, and shoot two. That is Petroisis. Her brother plays for Seward as well. I think he's a senior this year.
She just is a sophomore this year. And it's no good for the first shot. And no good for the second shot either. Up with the layup, and no good. Another layup, and it's good. Another 2 points for Seward.
Von Borsel there, able to use her body right there. Looks like her shoe came untied. She's playing defense with one foot. That is some karate stuff right there.
Seward's got the ball back.
Almost lost the ball there.
15 with the three, and it's no good. Cordova gains control, but it seems like the whistle has been blown. Well, pushing foul.
I think an offensive control foul right there. Didn't see exactly what happened there, but officials saw something, so they blew their whistle.
22 at the top for Cordova. Pass it to 42 in the corner. And Seward regains the possession.
Von Bolster there using her long arms there to get that steal. That's a good play there by her with her IQ and awareness. Looks like a double dribble was called there on Jackson.
22 on Cordova taking it to the top here. Looking for a play. Twenty at the top with the cut, and then 22 with the shot, and it's no good. Seward with the ball now. Number 10-22, 24 in the middle, shot no good. Cordova now has the ball. 12 taken to the top of the key here, looking for another play. Twenty-two just barely makes it to the passing zone there.
And that's going to be an out of bounds there. Seward will take possession once again. Cordova here struggling to, you know, get points on the board here. They had the 1-3 from Tabara at the beginning of the half, but haven't seen the bucket since.
Cordova with the ball. 12 passes it in the middle to 42, and 42 back to 12, and then to 22 in the corner. With the shot, and it's good.
That's Tabara again. Maybe I was wrong about her. She's looking like a dead-eye three-point shooter out here.
The score is now 20 to 25 with about 4 minutes remaining in the third quarter. And a good three by 22 on Seward. Score now 20 to 28 with 4 minutes remaining. Passes to 44 in the corner, and then to 42, and then to 20, but it seems like Seward regained possession of the ball.
Yeah, Von Borstel there using her IQ and awareness then to see the ball was being tipped, and she went after and got it.
Cordova back with the possession. .22 with the shot, and it's no good.
Fouled on the play there. Tabar going to the free throw line now.
Morgan, scoreboard. Scoreboard. Okay.
She goes with the first shot. And right off the back there. Second shot is no good, coming up the front of the rim. Seward gaining control. .22 passes it to 10 in the corner, and then 10 to 5 in the middle, and Cordova regains possession.
Cordova really playing some good defense here, just got to finish on the other end now.
Seemed to be taking the ball from them quite often.
Borges
and
from downtown.
12 with the three.
Cordova really hitting from the three-point line well. Two from Tabara, one from Borges.
Yeah. 33 with those 2 points, and it's no good. Let's see your number. And 24-7 for five here. Seward's still with the ball. Got a little shoe-tying delay there. And we're back on. Throws it to 10, back to 22 in the three line, and it's good.
That's Ashley Jackson there coming from the three-point line, splashing down a three.
.20 up top with the ball here, passes it to 12 in the corner. Back to 22 up top. 44 down low. Tries to hit it with the hook shot there, but seems to have get blocked. Two-man defense here. Off the foot of Cordova. Seward gaining control of the ball once again. Taking it to the top. Quickly passing it to 22. 22 to 24. And 15 on the three-point line.
Von Borstel there with the travel. Shuffling her feet a little too much right there. And needs to be more aware of what she's doing.
22 taking it up top. And 22 to 20 on Cordova. 42 to 20, and 32 up top of the ball, and a timeout called by Cordova coach.
So coming to the timeout here, Cordova, you know, they're shooting the ball decently well. Just you gotta play defense on the other end. Not being very efficient, allowing a lot of offensive rebounds, and allowing Seward just to do what they want. And on Seward's side, they're playing pretty well here. You know, you just got to limit the three balls from outside. Definitely they are they're really struggling to, you know, prevent the three ball. They're two for Tabara, one from Borges. I'm sure with this timeout, they're both going to figure out how to limit it. Maybe some denying action from off ball or some kind of press possibly. We'll see.
Score is now 23-31 with about a minute and a half remaining in the third quarter. Cordova still has a chance to catch up here. They just got to pick up their heads a little bit. All right, it looks like we're getting started again. Cordova with possession. Twelve bringing it up top here and passing 20 in the corner. Forty-four, but she misses, and number 10 on Seward regains the possession of the ball.
Right in the middle.
22 with the shot, and it's good.
That's actually Jackson again from downtown. Two threes in the third quarter here for her.
Cordova with the ball now. Defense! 20 with the cut, but changes her mind and passes it to 22 in the corner, and she shoots it, and it's a miss for her. Seward with the possession. 10 to 24 in the middle of the key, and then 24 to 33, and she makes it 2 points. And a timeout called by Seward.
So now up 13 here with about 33 seconds left here in the third quarter. Seward here is going to have the possession. You have to think they're probably going to go here for the last shot. If not, go for a two-for-one situation here. Maybe cause them to shoot the ball and come down score once again. Cordova here, you just got to play better defense. You can't be giving up those open threes, especially Ashley Jackson. She's hit two threes now in the last couple minutes. You got to be careful with her and her lightning shooting.
Yeah, I agree. With 30 seconds remaining on the clock. About 13 points down, Cordova. If you want to send us any cheers, go ahead and send it to a number to 702-276-7723, and we'll read them live here on the show. Cordova with possession now. Taking it up top once again. 44 with the ball in the corner, looking for a pass. And she passes to 12, and 12 with the shot off the back of the rim there. No good. Losing control, Seward regains possession and goes up with the layup, and it's no good. Up with another layup, and it's no good.
Fighting for the rebound right here. 5 seconds left.
15 with the three, and it's no good. 12 with the two, and it's no good.
So many offensive rebounds right there, and nothing to come up of it. That's kind of a sad possession right there. Four or five offensive rebounds there, and still no points up. Still up 13, though, so that's a comfortable lead going into the fourth quarter here.
If you'd like to make a donation to us, go ahead and send it to our school at Hutchinson High School in Fairbanks, Alaska. It's about a 7.5-hour drive for us here, a stream team. So if you can make donations, anything would help. And if you'd like to send in a cheer, go ahead and send it to the number 702-276-7723. And we'll read it here live for you. going into the fourth quarter with 13 up for Seward. Looks like we're starting up with the fourth quarter now. All right. Seward with possession. 15 with the shot, and it's no good. 24 with the ball and makes the shot, and there's the 2 points for Cordova. Or, I'm sorry, Seward. Cordova with possession. Makes the cut, but throws it right to the foot of 15 on Seward. Cordova's ball. All right, 12 with the drive and passes it to 22, and 22 with the shot. Ooh, just barely makes it. Out of bounds, but still Cordova's ball. And there's a sub. Looks like 15's going out for 22. Seeing all this movement, and 22 gets the possession of the ball. Passes it to 20. 12 with the shot on the three, and right off the front of the rim there, doesn't make it in. Seward with possession now. 22 with the 2 points, and it makes it in. 38 to 23. Cordova with possession. Passes it to 22. 22 looking for the pass. Decides to pass it to 44 in the corner. Back up top to 20. 44 in the middle. Pump fakes and passes it to 42 in the corner. The shot, and it misses. Out of bounds on green, and it is going to be Cordova's ball. Passes it to 42 in the corner. 42 to 20. Back to 12 in the corner. And it's no good. Fighting for that ball there. 42 seems to gain possession and make the 2 points.
Tough play right there. A lot of bodies around her trying to steal the ball from her, and she was able to rip through it and go up on the easy layup.
42 on Cordova gains possession. 12 takes it down the court. Passing into 20 in the corner. Back to 12. Making a high pass to 22. Off the leg and, oh, just barely saves it. And now Seward with the ball.
All that work for nothing right there. Just for a nice turnover.
With the shot. It's no good. Comes up the back there. And 33 with the layup. Another 2 points for Seward.
She came all the way from the outer rim right there and came and got that rebound there to go up and get the two easy bucket.
42 with the ball in the corner here for Cordova. 22 up top with the ball. Seward gains possession. 10 looking for the layup. Oh, she passes it to 12, and 12 makes the 2 for them.
Seward starting to pull away with this one. Up 19 now. It's looking really grim for Cordova.
Cordova passes it to 44 in the corner there and tries to pass it in the middle, but doesn't quite make it to the player. Cordova still has possession of the ball here. passes it to 22, just barely makes it to her hands there, but she couldn't quite save it. Passes it to the corner. Sewer 22 with the shot, and she makes it.
Right, kissing the glass, too, on that one. That's three threes for Jackson now in the second half.
Cordova with possession. Hard pass to 22, but doesn't quite make it to where she was trying to go.
Yeah, that's an over and back violation right there. Definitely bad decision making here late for Cordova. Down 22 now, about 4 minutes left.
Seward gains possession and 12 with the shot and misses. 22 now has the ball. Passes it to 10 up top and 24 in the key. Makes it. Another 2 points for Seward. Cordova with the ball, number 12, taking it up top and looking for the cut, but just another bad pass. Cordova still gains possession of the ball. And a timeout called by Cordova.
Alrighty, so about 3.5 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. Seward up 24. Definitely looking more towards Seward here with the last 3 minutes left, but I don't know how the Cordova coach is going to play it, if he wants him to keep fighting. Or are they just going to put in the bench here, you know, get the younger guys some minutes here in a varsity level game. We'll have to see. This is kind of one of those moments where coaches choose whether to you know, give it up or to keep fighting. To me, the game's surely not over yet. If they can get on a little bit of a run here, give it to either Tabara or Navarro for three, and maybe we could see a possible comeback here.
About 3.5 minutes left. Cordova has possession and 22 with the outside shot on the three line and doesn't quite make it through the basket. Seward with possession, 22 taking it down the court. Looking for the pass and makes the long shot over there to 12 in the corner. Then to 30. Five down low, but trips over a foot.
Stays here though. Yeah, it looked like she tripped over the leg of Vargas and
22 getting the ball and running for the layup, but can't seem to gain control quick enough. Pope looking for the shot, and she shoots it. Doesn't make it. Makes it off, or bounces off the back of the rim. Out of bounds, Cordova's ball. Right over the head of 42 there.
Almost into the concession stand. That would have been a mess.
Now it is Seward's ball. With the ball. Looking for the pass. Passes it to 15. 22 with the 2 points. And she makes it. Another 2 points for Seward.
Ashley Jackson's on a tear right now, hitting the kiss in the glass once again, once from the three-point line, and now from the elbow. She's having a nice game, at least around 15 to 20 points at least. And really, Ashley Jackson's the reason why Seward's up right now. There's a couple of threes in the beginning of the second half.
Cordova with a three and no good. And another hit to the floor there.
Bodies flying. I mean, I don't know what it is. These girls are all over the place. If they're on the floor because they tripped or they're diving for the ball, they are falling.
Seward with the ball. And Cordova not letting up on their defense. Still goes out of bounds, though.
Playing to the last whistle. That's the best kind of mentality you can have as a basketball player, regardless if you're up 100, down 100. Always play to the last whistle.
Yep. Seward's ball now. 22 taking it down the court. Loses control a little bit there, but regains it pretty quick. 24 up top here. We've seen her, seem to have seen her in the middle more. But right. Cordova with the ball now. And 22 with the outside. Decided to pass it to 44. The whistle's blown.
That was Kerensky, or, yeah, Sarensky right there. Fouled her on the little push right there. Don't need to foul here with about 2 minutes left here. You're up 26 points. Kind of.
20 with the layup, but doesn't quite make it. And again, these girls are on the floor.
Yeah, we. Coach for Cordova got a timeout there, full timeout here for him. So 2 minutes left in this game. Seward's up 26 points. You got to be thinking at the Cordova coach, you know, it's about playing for pride now. You know, start bringing in the younger girls. Give them some minutes in this game. You know, give them some experience on the floor. It's not often you get to come to a lot of these tournaments like this and, you know, get to play against a lot of great competition. And, you know, allowing a lot of some of the younger girls to get in the game, you know, get a feel for that varsity level, because once those starters and the older people graduate, it's going to be them coming in and getting a lot of those minutes. So definitely need to, you know, look at a possibly get those young girls some minutes. And then on the Seward end, too, same thing, you know. You're up 26 right now. No reason to keep the starters in, risk injury or any kind of nonsense. You know, let the younger girls play. Let them get some minutes in. Get a feel for that, you know, how to control a lead, things like that. It's the little things that matter.
I agree here. Looks like we're starting back up. Cordova with the ball. Passes it to 20 in the corner. Looking for the layup, but the defense seems to be strong, and 12 shoots from the outside. Doesn't quite make it in there.
Ooh, that looked like that hurt. She hit the rubber hard.
Got right back up, though.
That's one thing I got to say. A lot of these basketball players, girls and guys, have been taking a lot of hits. You know, they keep fighting through it. Like, there was a couple of bloody noses yesterday. It looked like the girl from Hutch, Kriska, broke her nose. She took an elbow right and straight in the middle of her nostrils, and it looked like she was done.
22 with the outside shot. No good. 42 with the close shot. No good either. Got about four bodies on the floor this time.
That right there, that was Sarensky again on the floor right there, kind of rolling around, trying to figure out who to give the ball to right there. Kind of did a little bit of a barrel roll.
Cordova still has the ball. Seward's making sure their defense is strong in the middle there. 42 makes a shot, but makes it off the back of the rim and doesn't make it in. Seward packing in the middle there. 20 with the outside shot. Makes it off the front of the rim, doesn't make it in.
About a minute 15 left in this game. Yeah, time to kind of wind down here as, maybe not.
Cordova steals the ball back.
Ooh, bounce pass.
And misses the shot.
Solid bounce pass there, right on the dime there. You just got to finish the layup there. It was a good look there by, I think that was Borges.
Probably just felt the pressure there. And 12 with the outside shot, misses.
On Borstel here. It's trapped.
Pushing through, but steps out of bounds.
Gotta be careful with that out of bounds line right there. She was getting trapped, and she thought she could dribble through it and ended up dribbling out of bounds.
22 up top here with about 45 seconds left in the game. Looking for a pass, but can't see one. 42 in the middle, wide open. Makes another 2 points.
Cashing in there, that's Peebles. Known for that little elbow jumper there, especially kissing right off the glass right here. And we got a full timeout here with about 23 seconds left in this game. that time I was taken by Seward right there. I probably just had to talk some things over, probably some kind of delay, kind of offense, slow down the pace right here, end this game really quick. But since we're here, if you want to text in any kind of cheers or you want to send in a shout-out to the stream team or any of the cheerleaders, send them in at 702-276-7723. Yet again, the number is 702-276-7723. Me or Chantel or whoever's up here will be reading off those texts live on screen for you.
Got about 23 seconds here. It's time to be back on the court.
I'm sure you'll see Seward probably run up the clock here. No reason to shoot another shot up here. You're up 24. You just need to slow it down a little bit.
Seward with possession. 33 with the ball. 10 seconds on the clock. It just seems to be killing time here. 2-1. And that's game.
That was kind of crazy right there. She got caught in the corner there. I thought they were going to steal and, you know, try to hook something up there.
Seward with the win here.
Definitely a close game in the beginning, first half of it, and then Seward kind of just pulled away with their offensive ability and kind of, you know, playing really good defense there, especially in the fourth quarter there, you know, up a little bit, you know, you don't want to slack off at all. You know, they played really solid.
Yeah, and we here have actually some slideshows for you from highlights of the third and fourth quarter, so let's get right to it.